Well, with us now for more in our Rockwall studio in Makati is Nina Aguas, the executive chairman of Insular Life. Good to see you, Nina. Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Kathy. Thank you for having me.
So 2018 has really been a tough year, as it's been for the Philippine insurance firms. How did the rapid spikes in inflation rates limit your growth among revenue sources last year?
There were alternative investments that we were looking at, and that in a sense made it a little tougher for us. But on the main business, which is growing the gross premium, the top line for Insular Life, we've had some successes, primarily driven by the bank assurance, as well as our strengthening our agency force.
Now tell us,
agency business.
Yeah, now that interest rates are starting to come off this year, what is your forecast for monetary policy, and how do you see it impacting the Philippine insurance industry?
I think there will be better investment outlets for many of the insurance companies, us included. And we're looking at several alternatives, and to participate, for example, in the PPP, if those give us attractive yields, we'll be able to get in. As a consequence of that, we'll be able to make better offerings to our policyholders that are into investments and protection at the same time.
So what are you considering in the PPP space, public-private sector space, being involved in the Philippine government's infrastructure program?
Yes, we're really looking at more on the green and for sustainability and for the environment. So hopefully there will be some that will be made available to us, as well as the REITs, no?
But what sort of returns can we get when we talk about green and sustainable investments? I mean, what's the return for your company?
The investment, for example, that we made with the IFC green bonds is giving us to the extent 6 to 7% return over a period of time. And so that's the sort of thing we're looking at.
Now, what about the Philippine peso? It's continually strengthening over the past few weeks. Are you expecting it to strengthen or weaken for the remainder of this year? And what sort of impact is it going to have in your business?
We are primarily a local company, and we don't have any foreign liabilities in a sense. But at the same time, we do have our dollar or foreign denominated investments. And if it gets stronger, it's actually like good for us, or it could be not so good for us. It depends on the position that we hold.
So is it going to be a net good or a net bad if the peso continues to strengthen?
Not bad, I think, on the whole, because we are really a peso company, a local currency company in that sense.
All right. Well, let's talk about the bank assurance channel now that it's delivering results. What drove bank assurance production on a tough year as 2018? And where do you see it headed this year?
It will continue to deliver for us, primarily because we have a very good partner in Union Bank of the Philippines. Culturally, we're very connected. And we are invested in Union Bank, so we have like our heart there and a seriousness about making it succeed. We're both like delivering with the main bank, which is the Union Bank, as well as the city savings.
And that brings us to the digitalization of the financial industry. InLife's digital technologies, that also helped your revenues. What's been the take-up so far for the online initiatives, and what impact is it having on your agency force?
First, we are really actually gunning for the most digitally connected life insurance provider. And we've been very successful there with our automated underwriting system, but we could decision a policy, for example, within 25 minutes from prospecting till payments. And we are into the paperless insurance policy contracts, no? So we're able to deliver that within a 25-minute time frame. In fact, like paperless provides us two ways of like servicing the customer. He will be able to see his policy contract even before the agent or the financial advisor could physically deliver it to him. And second, also for our underwriting, we've experienced a lot of cost savings because of it.
Now you've
so
also,
that's one aspect.
Yeah. I know that you've created solutions that protect and add value to Filipino women. How is that coming along?
Yes. Oh, that's coming along very well as we speak. In fact, like, we are trying to bridge the knowledge gap about risk protection for not just for the Filipino, but particularly for the Filipino woman. And we've partnered with International Finance Corporation, a partner of the World Bank, primarily to do these things. We saw a study, She for Shield, ensure women to better protect all. And we were inspired by that, essentially, and we created our own, which is In Life, Sheroes, She, the Hero.
And what returns are you expecting from these solutions for 2019?
For 2019, it's a startup, if you consider it that. And we're hoping to touch 1 million lives in 3 years and more as the years ahead. But the advocacy and the mission of In Life Sheroes goes beyond insular life. I really want to be able to ask all the providers of life insurance to, in fact, touch as many women as possible, because I think it's a 200 billion peso business in 2020. And the more we are into this area and supporting the women in the Philippines, who I think is the shero really of a family, because she's the nucleus. And I always think about them in metaphors as the natural ecosystem, supporting the entire family from the elderly parents, their children, their siblings, etc. And then they have to go to work and provide to the economic and financial coffers of the family. And when something happens to her, the whole family is reset. And they'll have to pick up the pieces. And it's very difficult and challenging because they all look up to the woman to be able to do this for everyone.
Nina, just a final point. You've also had non-financial highlights to report on, such as the ASEAN Corporate Governance Scorecard. Why is this important?
As a mutual company, corporate governance is one strong point that we must have and possess. It is the corporate governance culture and framework that must permeate the entire organization, starting from the board of trustees. We don't have significant investors, for example, that could look out for corporate governance, so that it's very important for us to be governed properly by the board of trustees and by senior management and the rest of the organization to follow. So getting 104 points versus the ASEAN corporate governance score, where the rest of the industry on average is about 60, 65 points, I think speaks to how serious we are in looking at corporate governance as a way of running insular life.
All right. Well, thank you so much for keeping us up to speed in the back half of 2019. All the best. Nina Aguas, the Executive Chair of
Insular
Life in Makati.
Maraming salamat.